Hello, geometry. All right, I am helping you with V6 today, find properties of circles from equations in general form. So you know that this problem right here is in general form, and we know that because it says equals zero. So when it says properties of circles, we're usually typically trying to find the radius or the center. Now, think about general form versus standard form. Which form would you prefer to have? I hope you're all saying standard form because you know that standard form gives you a lot more information than general form, right? If we see an equation in standard form, we can identify the center and the radius. Now, these types of problems are going to be easier for me to show you on a separate sheet of paper rather than me trying to draw it out with this marker because y'all know my handwriting is terrible with a pen, so definitely don't need to be doing this. All right, so I'm going to show you a separate sheet of paper. What I did was I copied this equation onto a separate sheet of paper, and then we'll come back to the screen in a second. All right. All right. So looking at this, I wrote the problem down. X squared plus y squared minus 81 equals 0. And then I wrote some little notes over here for standard form. So looking at this, you'll see x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared is our standard form. And from there, we know that h and k are the center. Now, to get the center from my equation, I have to switch the signs, right? Because the negative signs, the minus signs are in the equation. And then to get the radius, I need to take the square root of whatever constant's on the right side. All right, so let's get started. This one's actually pretty easy because we don't have all the terms that we normally would have with general form. Remember, general form ax squared plus by squared plus cx plus dy plus e equals 0. So you can see we usually have an x squared, a y squared, an x term, a y term, and a constant. Here, we only have the x squared term, the y squared term, and the constant, which makes it easier for us because we don't have to go through the process of completing the square to get it into standard form. So the first thing we always do is move the constant to the other side, and to do that, we use inverse operation. So what we need to do is add 81 to both sides. All right, let's move these two terms down here. X squared plus y squared equals 81. And we're done, just because there is no other terms, so I don't need to complete the square at this point. So looking at this, I can identify the center and the radius. If we just have x squared by itself, and there's nothing in parentheses with it, we know that the x value of the center must be 0. Y squared is also by itself. There's no k with it, so the y value must also be 0. This circle is centered at the origin, 0, 0. All right, now we need to take the square root of the constant on the right side to get the radius, and the square root of 81 is 9. So let's go back and see what the problem asks us for, either the center or the radius. Looks like it asks us for the radius, so let's go ahead and put in 9. All right. All right, I went ahead and got ahead in IXL to get to a more difficult problem that you might encounter. So looking at this, we're trying to find the radius of the circle, but this time we actually do have a y term right here, this minus 13y. So that means we're going to be completing the square for the y values of this equation. All right, so let me go back to my sheet of paper. All right. So looking at this, I went ahead and I wrote the equation down. Now we need to get it into standard form, and we're going to do that by completing the square. Step number one, move the constant. The constant is the number without any variable, this 36. So we're going to do the opposite of what's in front of it. So if it's a plus 36, we're going to subtract 36 on both sides of the equation. All right, let's move everything else down. X squared plus y squared minus 13y equals a negative 36. All right, so looking at this, there's no other x term. That means I'm done with my x squared. I'm done with it. Just go ahead and drop it down, x squared. Now, with the y squared, I do have a y term, so that means I'm going to need to complete the square. So to do that, I need to draw my blanks on both sides of the equation. What I add on one side, I have to add on the other. All right, so you should have downloaded Desmos by now onto your phone, or you can go to Desmos online. All right, so I hope you guys remember what goes in the blank, but just in case, I'm going to go ahead and write that here. Complete the square. Complete the square. We do that by taking middle term coefficient, which just is a fancy way of saying the number in front of the middle term, divide it by 2, and square it. Okay, I rewound in the video because I got far using decimals, but I realized that wouldn't work when you submit your answers to IXL because it asks you to put it in the most simplified rational form. So we need to keep fractions in terms of fractions and not convert them to decimals. So to get our step 2 of completing the square, we took the middle term, negative 13, we're going to divide that by 2, and we're going to square it. So remember, squaring just means you multiply something by itself. So I can rewrite this to look just like this. Negative 13 over 2 times negative 13 over 2. Now, when we're multiplying fractions, just multiply the two numerators and multiply the two denominators. So on top, we're going to do negative 13 times negative 13. And that's going to give us a positive 169. And you know that's positive because a negative times a negative gives you a positive. And then 2 times 2 is 4. So this is actually what goes here and here. So 169 over 4 and 169 over 4. Don't let that intimidate you. It's just a fraction. We'll just work with it. So this kind of shows you how we got that number. And we plugged it in up here. So I'm going to rewrite this equation just so we can see it more clearly. All right, so this is where we're at. All right, we got two things to do here. We need to rewrite this as a binomial squared, which essentially means we just need to factor it. All right, so I'm going to bring my x squared down, plus we're going to call this y minus 13 divided by 2 squared. That's all this is. Whenever we factor it, we're just taking the middle term and dividing it by 2. So if I expanded this out using FOIL method or box method, it would look like this trinomial. All right. And then we're going to say equals. Now we need to combine these two fractions. To add fractions together, they need to have a common denominator. This one obviously does not have a common denominator. We need to change this fraction to have the same denominator as this one. Now remember, a whole number is anything over 1, right? So I can write this as negative 36 over 1. Now to get negative 36 to have a denominator of 4, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to multiply the top number and the bottom number by 4. 4 over 4 is the same thing as 1, so I'm not changing this number in any way, right? Anything multiplied by 1 is still itself. So let's do negative 36 times 4. We're going to get negative 144. Negative 144. Let me focus this. And then 1 times 4 is 4. So negative 144 over 4 plus 169 over 4. So now that I have a common denominator, I can add the two numerators. Negative 144 plus 169. That's going to give me 25. So again, just rewrite everything. X squared plus y minus 13 over 2 squared is going to equal 25 over 4. All right, so from here, I've got everything I need. This is standard form, right? So let's go ahead and write our center and our radius. or center. My x value is 0, and my y value, remember, all I need to do is change the sign. So since it's a negative in here, I'm going to make it a positive 13 over 2. So if it asked us for the center, that's what I'd be putting. Now remember, if it asks us for the radius, we need to take the square root of this, right? Because standard form is equal to r squared. So this number on the right side is my radius squared. So all I need to do is take the square root of 25 over 4. Okay, I put in the square root of 25 over 4 into my Desmos app, and it tells me 2.5. All right, I don't want to use any decimals when I put it into IXL. So looking at this, I want to see if what I can do is make this into a more simple form. So I'm taking the square root of this fraction, so I can just take the square root of the denominator and the numerator. So what would the square root of 25 be? Square root of 25 is 5. And then what's the square root of 4? That's 2. Are these two things the same thing, 2.5 and 2.5? Yes, they are. So what I can do is my final answer is going to be 5 over 2. So this is going to equal 5 over 2. So all I did was take the square root of the numerator and the denominator, 5 over 2. So let's go back to our screen and put this in. Fraction, 5 over 2. All right, last one. I'm going to go ahead and write this out on a separate sheet of paper. Okay, I've got this written on a separate sheet of paper. All right, so we're doing the same thing. The first thing we need to do is move the constant. So since it's a negative 21, we're going to add 21 to both sides. I'm going to bring everything else down just the way I see it, and that 21 is over on the other side. All right, now you'll notice that my x group does not have a middle term, so I don't need to worry about that. My x group is done. I do need to complete the square with my y group because I do have a y middle term. All right, so looking at this, remember I'm going to take the middle term coefficient, which in this case is a negative 4, and I'm going to do negative 4 divided by 2, and I'm going to square it. So negative 4 divided by 2 is going to give me a negative 2. And once I square that, that's going to leave me back to 4. So I completed my square. So now I know what should go in both those blanks. 4, right? I divided that middle coefficient by 2 and I squared it. So I'm going to put a 4 here and a 4 here. All right, my next step is to factor this down into a binomial squared. So I'm going to bring my x squared down. And this is going to become y minus 2. It becomes this number right here. The negative 4 divided by 2 gives me a negative 2. Equals 21 plus 4 gives me 25. All right, I'm done. This is my standard form. So at this point, I know my center and I know my radius. So my center is going to be 0, positive 2, because that's a negative and I need to change the sign. The x value is 0 because there's nothing next to it. And then my radius is going to be the square root of that constant on the other side. And the square root of 25 is 5. So I think the problem asks us for the center, so we're going to put in 0, 2. All right, that's it. You can email me or request a Zoom virtual tutoring session if you're still having issues with this IXL.